In this episode, you'll learn how to implement the front end with HTML and JavaScript to accept a one-time payment with a custom form. If you're interested in a faster integration path for accepting card payments, head over to the checkout playlist in the Stripe Developers channel. Let's say you've already got a backend set up to create payment intents, and you want to add support for accepting the card payment method on the front end. If you haven't already implemented a backend, head over and take a look at one of the server implementations. Link those in the description. If you're using React, iOS, or Android, we have videos specific to those clients linked in the description. So our backend is up and running. It has two endpoints that we'll interact with today. One is /config for fetching publishable keys, and one is /create payment intent, which takes the payment method type and a currency as arguments, and it returns a client secret for a payment intent that we can use to confirm payment on the front end. Let's open index.html in the client directory and get to work. So we're going to rename the page to accept a payment. And before we write any JavaScript, the page needs a form element where customers can enter their payment details. So technically you can just collect the card details, but we'll also want to collect the customer's name and email to pass along with the billing details. So I'm pre-populating the values here so that we don't have to fill them out every time we test out the form. Next, we want to create an input control where customers can enter their card details. The simplest way to do so is with a single div where we'll mount the single line card element. Now, if you'd like, you can also separate out the card number, expiration, CVC, and postal code into individual inputs. We'll also add a simple div below our form for debugging and so that we can see some log messages without needing to open up the console. We're almost ready to jump into JavaScript, so let's install Stripe.js. And Stripe.js should always be loaded directly from js.stripe.com, and it is a best practice to load it on every page. Okay, so next we're going to add a reference to card.js to pull in the JavaScript that we're going to write and to handle the form submission. So refreshing the browser, we'll see the name and email inputs, but no card input to be seen. That's because we need to create and mount that card element. So from card.js, let's do some setup. I'm going to drop in this little helper function for logging to that messages div. This is purely for demonstration. We grab reference to the div, set its display, and then we add some inner HTML with the string of the message. We're also going to console log here so that we have a couple chances to see this message. All right, time for the meat and potatoes of today's demo. So we're going to start with a wrapper so that our code only runs when the DOM is fully loaded. Then we'll initialize Stripe. This Stripe constructor function comes from Stripe.js that we just installed earlier, and it expects the publishable key as the first argument as a string. You can find your API keys in the Stripe dashboard. Next, we'll create the one-line card element and mount it inside of the div we created earlier that has the ID card-element. Now, at this point, when we refresh the page, we'll see that our form has loaded and our card input is waiting for some of those juicy card details. And when the form is submitted, we'll hit the back end to create a payment intent and then confirm it on the front end. So let's walk through that. We prevent the default so that the browser doesn't reload and make a full post request to the back end. Then we're going to make an AJAX call to our server to create the payment intent, and we'll store the result here in this client secret variable. So there are several libraries and packages that help with making AJAX requests. You might be using jQuery or Axios or $HTTP from Angular or similar. In this case, we're using the browser's native fetch API to avoid any dependencies. Here we specify the currency and the payment method type. Technically, you could attempt to derive the currency based on the customer's location or locale or something fancy, but for now, we're just going to hard code it. Now, in this demo, we're showing how to accept card payments, but in other videos in this series, you'll see how to accept other payment method types like Alipay or SEPA Direct Debit or Ideal or ShiroPay and more. Also worth mentioning that you could technically hard code a list of supported payment method types on the back end, but our server expects that we're going to pass this payment method type and currency so that we can demonstrate the widest variety of payment method type and currency combinations. All right, let's add a little bit of logging here. Cool, so now that we have the client secret for the payment intent, we can confirm that. So we're gonna call confirm card payment, which expects the client secret from the payment intent earlier, and an options block with reference to a payment method. Now, if your customer has already provided a payment method, you can pass the string value for that payment method ID here instead of an object, but we're gonna pass an object and we're passing reference to that card element. Note this is the same card element reference from the one we created above and is the one that's managing that card input control we see on the form. So in addition to the card details, we'll also pass the name and email as billing details that will be assigned to the payment method that's going to be created. So this confirm card payment method does a ton of heavy lifting for us. It's going to send a client-side request with the raw card details directly to the Stripe API to confirm the payment intent, and it'll both create a payment method, also known as tokenizing, and it'll attempt to confirm. So if the payment intent wasn't able to confirm because it requires next actions, as is the case with secure customer authentication, then Stripe.js will open a modal or redirect to handle any of those next steps for the payment. Finally, confirm card payment will resolve either a payment intent object or an error. All right, so let's take this for a spin. We're going to enter the 4242 test card and a future expiration and any CVC and any postal code and hit pay. All right, success. So we see the payment succeeded and the ID of the payment intent. Let's copy that and take a look at the payment in the Stripe dashboard. So here we see the payment method that was used and a few more details about the payment. From the Stripe documentation, we can head over and copy another test card. So this one that ends in 3178 will both open the SCA challenge modal and it will fail the test payment for insufficient funds. So let's give it a try. We see the SCA test modal and no status message was actually printed, but that's because we don't actually have any error handling yet. So it's time, I guess, to clean this up, make this code a little bit more flexible and robust. So let's add some error handling to both our AJAX call for creating the payment intent and for the confirmation step. So the JSON return from our server and the JSON return from Stripe will follow the same pattern in a failure case. So a JSON object with the top level error key pointing at some subhash or subobject with a message, a string message that we can display to the user. Because both APIs respond with an object called error, we'll use an alias when destructuring the response. So we'll pull the error responses off and add some basic logging if there's a failure from either the call to confirm the payment or the call to our backend to create the payment intent. Now, if we try the card with insufficient funds, we'll see that the error is printed and it tells us that our card does not have enough funds to make this purchase. One last bit of cleanup, let's load the publishable key from the server with an AJAX call and use that to initialize Stripe. Run a real quick smoke test to confirm that we're good to go, this time with an SCA test card that will succeed after the SCA challenge. And excellent, again, we're seeing succeeded. So in review, we first created an HTML form for users to enter some billing details and card information. Next, we initialized Stripe, created and mounted an element. Then we added a form handler to create this payment intent, where we passed in the currency and the payment method type to the server. And then finally, we confirmed that payment intent client-side with Stripe.js using the client secret from the payment intent. You're now fully equipped to build a custom payment flow to accept a one-time card payment with Stripe. Head over and watch the other videos in the playlist to see how to accept different types of payment methods. And as always, if you have any feedback, please let us know by completing that form linked in the description. Thanks so much, and we'll see you next time.